I want to cover some basics of chemistry very quickly. You're probably familiar with this, but it wouldn't hurt to review. In chemistry, we deal with chemical formulas. These are the essentially the molecules, although sometimes we don't use that word, for all of the matter that we see. Chemical formulas might include only an atom. For example, a sample of sodium has the chemical formula Na because that's the symbol for sodium, so it might be that simple. There are certain elements on the periodic table that exist as diatomic molecules in nature, for example, hydrogen. So the chemical formula for hydrogen is not simply H, but H2, where the 2 subscript indicates that there are 2 hydrogen atoms in a molecule of hydrogen. That's the way that it exists in nature. There are 7 diatomic elements. It's in your best interest to learn them. They are hydrogen, nitrogen, so nitrogen would be written as N2, oxygen, which would be written as O2, fluorine, F2, chlorine, Cl2, bromine, Br2, and iodine, which is written as I2. Let me make that a little neater. All right, these 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, again, you should learn them because it's going to make your life easier in the long run. If you look at a periodic table, as you look at these 7 elements, you'll see where they are. That kind of helps you remember them. Or there's a mnemonic device that you might find interesting. It is Brinkelhoff. Brinkelhoff. These are the 7 diatomic elements. But again, these are the formulas. Each one of these different colors is the formula for that element. Molecules or compounds, we also can call them formula units, have more complicated formulas. For example, water is H2O. The 2 subscript means 2 hydrogens. There's only 1 oxygen. We do not need the 1 subscript. It's understood. A 1 subscript is understood. Anything besides a 1 should be explicitly listed. In an ionic compound, all right, you would list the ions. You might need some parentheses. Let me make this real. For example, in this particular formula, we have 1 calcium atom in this formula. We have 2 nitrogen atoms because the parentheses around NO3 means it's like saying there's NO3 and then another NO3. And for oxygens, there are a total of 6. Another way of looking at this formula, although we wouldn't write it this way, but you can see this is like a CaNO3, NO3. Watch your uppercase and lowercase letters. That does make a difference. So you can see there's 1 calcium, there are my 2 nitrogens, and there are my 6 oxygens. So if you have parentheses with a subscript, that subscripted number stands for everything inside of the parentheses. If we can do another one that's maybe a little more complicated, if we see something like this. All right, we have 3 magnesiums, we have 2 phosphoruses, and again with our oxygens, we do see 6 here. So you should be able to write formulas. You'll learn how to do this as we go throughout the semester, but right now, as you see a formula, you should be able to interpret it in terms of how many of each type of atom. Another thing that we're going to use throughout the semester are chemical reactions. If we look at a simple chemical reaction, we would see something, for example, written like this. All right, this is an example of what we call a balanced chemical reaction. In a chemical reaction, on the left, the first part of it, before the arrow, which divides it in half, these are the reactants. On the right-hand side of the arrow, these are the products. The arrow indicates the reaction is happening. We often say the word yield when we read the arrow, so I might say 3 hydrogens react with 1 nitrogen to produce or to yield two ammonias. This is the formula for ammonia. So I have reactants, yield, products, and then the numbers that I have over here balance the chemical reaction for atoms. If I look at this example, I see three H2 molecules, and so there are six hydrogens on the left. This is like an H2 plus an H2 plus an H2 for my reactants. I see two nitrogen atoms on the left, and then on the right, the two NH3, this is like an NH3 plus another NH3. So I see two nitrogens and six hydrogens. And so since I see the same number of each atom on the left and the right, we say that this reaction is balanced. We'll talk more later about how to balance it from scratch, but at this point, you can see that this is indeed a balanced reaction by counting up the number of atoms on both sides. We don't count molecules or formulas, we count individual atoms, and so you need to be able to use these subscripts to indicate that how many of each atom there are.